Slavery in Iron Age Britain almost certainly was occurring long before the Romans arrived.
Rarely we have slave chains from a number of late Iron Age sites, places like Bigbury in Kent, where we can see the manacles dating to the late Iron Age. We must remember that there may have been other forms of keeping slaves, fetters that just don't survive archaeologically. So there was perhaps more of it going on.
When the Romans arrive on the doorstep, if you like, it probably had a catalysing effect in Britain. The slave chains we have from Camulodunum are Roman, but it's symptomatic, I think, of something that was happening before the Romans even arrive.
Slave chains are, first of all, one of the very few bits of evidence that we have that directly represent slaves and slavery. You know, the archaeological record is obviously very sparse in that regard, but we do get slave chains in the late Iron Age period. The way they work is we get these gang chains, we call them gang chains because they connect several people. And the way they work is they've got collars that go around, and the collars don't actually have the same kind of locking mechanism that you would imagine a chain to have now. They interlock with each other, and basically the way to open them is to release the next one down. So everyone's locked in together. The chains themselves, when we look at them, they're such heavy objects. I mean, it's gang chains, so it's several, but even if you just pick up one bit of it, you realize how heavy it is. And it went around people's necks, you know, depriving them of their liberty, but also tying them to other people. So even in that moment, depriving them of the ability to move freely. They're incredibly impactful objects because so much of the information we get about slavery isn't directly related to our archaeological record. It's also worth mentioning that when we think about Roman slavery, we very often think about the conquered people. We think about warfare and the consequence of warfare. And there's something horrendous about that as well. But in late Iron Age Britain, people are actually being sold by people, very often within Britain, to Romans. And there's a huge increase in demand as the Romans are expanding within the continent. And it seems to be this practice that the Romans see as almost essential to their way of life, so that the more they expand, the more slaves they need to get into their borders.